We made a video very recently talking about Godzilla and the possibility of the MonsterVerse and the Pacific Rim universe being a shared universe. You can go over and check that video via the card. And in this video, we're going to be talking about the possibility of what would happen if Godzilla was in Pacific Rim, like if he were to be teleported from his world into Pacific Rim. How would the Kaiju act? How would the people who are responsible for national security behave? Well, for one thing, Godzilla would be treated just like another kaiju. As far as they're concerned, there is no difference. They all come from the hollow earth and the sea, and they're terrible, destructive creatures. But the only time Godzilla would surface is to take care of these things. It's not like the 2019 version of Godzilla, which is the Godzilla we're talking about, rampages and destroys cities. Or as Dr. Chen said, not yet, or for now, he's on our side. So there is a possibility that later down the line, Godzilla may just say to hell with the humans and go on a rampaging spree. But for now, he seems to fight other kaiju. That's the only thing that he takes care of. And if they go on land, he will only go to the surface to fight those kaiju and then leave. He doesn't have anything against the humans. They're his little bees, so he doesn't really have an issue with them unless they target him exactly. But initially, everyone would treat Godzilla just like one of these kaiju and they would try to kill him. They would send out the Jaegers and try to kill this thing, and he would be in one of the most powerful categories, because what they'd find is that Godzilla, the only time they see him, as I mentioned just now, is when he's killing or kicking other kaiju's asses. And kicking their asses, he would. The kaiju there, even the biggest ones, are not enough to take on Godzilla. We have to remember that size does matter, but it really isn't everything. And I know in some other videos that I did say that, well, if something like and Caligon were to go up against Godzilla and how heavy they are and how big they are, they would definitely crush him, but within reason. Some of the kaiju that exist are a little bigger than Godzilla, but it doesn't necessarily mean they're as dense as he is. He has very densely packed muscles, and that's why he weighs basically 100,000 pounds, and these kaiju don't seem to weigh that much. He would fillet them with his breath. Now, while there are kaiju that spit substances and have other weapons, they started evolving to be more formidable. At the moment, with the kaiju that we've seen displayed on the movie, not considering the second one, that doesn't count, but the kaiju that were displayed in Pacific Rim, they are a lot weaker than Godzilla from what we've seen displayed. Surely some of them, like the flying ones, would probably tire him out some. But if something like these Jaegers are able to be ripped apart by them quite easily if they work together, then the Jaegers wouldn't even be a problem for Godzilla. Of course, we believe that some could hurt him, but there's only a specific way I believe they would hurt him for good, and I'll talk about that in a little bit. But as for the kaiju, Godzilla wouldn't see it as any issue, but the only time it could get a little bit annoying for him is if they team up on him like they did in Pacific Rim. We saw Leatherback and Otachi teaming up together, so they may do something similar to this in Pacific Rim against Godzilla, especially if they see him as a new and more formidable threat. This would tire out Godzilla, but the other thing he has working for him is that he can regenerate quite rapidly. This is something I always bring up because it is an important feature that Godzilla has that could mean winning the fight. While he may tire out quickly than these other kaiju do, he can recuperate a lot faster. Now, where Godzilla would surely be defeated is if the Jaegers see him as a threat and they make a weapon, and after studying him and researching how he works, to inject into Godzilla with enough force to suck out his nuclear energy or just to deplete his energy. The way they killed Adam or Dagon from the 2014 Godzilla, that skeleton that we saw lying there at the beginning, that is how that creature died, at the hands or the jaws or proboscis of another creature, Muto Prime. If the Jaegers could do this or formulate a weapon that could do this to basically suck out Godzilla's life force, or even if the kaiju were to evolve to do this, then Godzilla wouldn't stand a chance. And the fact that these kaiju seem to team up and work together, even though Godzilla could beat these monsters one-on-one and he would be top dog for a while, he wouldn't stay that way. Because it's one thing about the Pacific monsters, is every time they took Jaegers out to go and defeat these things, those monsters were made stronger and more brutal, so that they could defeat the Jaegers, and they had to keep making, changing their fight tactics or make better technology. We actually saw the evolution of these creatures as time went by, and so Godzilla being the mix, he would either have to adapt as fast as they are adapting, or find another kaiju to team up with. Now, the other question is, would they listen to him? In the MonsterVerse, he is proven as the alpha, and so they listen to him. Well, the only way that the kaiju would listen to him is if he bests other kaiju all the time. Now, initially, the other monsters may listen, but they see him as a different species, because if you remember in Pacific Rim, it was like this alien kind of species that had made these things. So we have to also remember that Godzilla isn't the same type of kaiju these things are, even though I do have a theory about that. But let's say that Godzilla is just a regular creature from prehistoric times or predating prehistoric times. He's not an alien. As far as we're concerned, these alien things are different. So the kaiju are probably not going to listen to him. You know why? Because of what I said in the other videos. They have their own alpha. Just like the Muchos had Muta Prime, just like the Skullcrawlers had their alpha, and just like the animals on Skull Island have Kong, it seems to be that as what's his name said about, who was it? Not Charles Dance. The father, Madison's father in Godzilla King of the Monsters, he mentioned that the kaiju in the MonsterVerse behave like pack animals. They find an alpha. Well, it depends on which pack you're with. Different packs will have their own alpha. And as long as there is a kaiju in a specific region that has their own alpha, they're not going to just kneel down to another unless that kaiju defeats their alpha. All of that being said, chances are the kaiju wouldn't even listen to Godzilla. He would kill off quite a few of them, and then they would make more powerful kaiju, and then they would send up two at a time, then three at a time, then four at a time, because they were popping out faster. And that was the issue and where the plot had thickened in the Pacific Rim movie, because as the little portal was getting bigger, they were just popping out these things even faster. They were appearing faster, and there was more of them popping out through this place. So by the time we turn around, Godzilla would have to contend with six kaiju at one point. And he would have defeated all those other kaiju before these ones popped out, the new ones, so that the aliens or the makers down there would realize that the only way to beat him is if they're more powerful and if they study him and eventually learns what makes him tick so they can defeat him. That's how they operate. So the kaiju themselves are not as intelligent as Godzilla, but because they pop out like candy, in a short space of time, Godzilla would be dealing with bigger and badder kaiju. Everyone that's been presented so far in Pacific Rim, I think he can beat, but as time went on, he would make even bigger, the alien creatures would make even bigger kaiju. Eventually, Godzilla would be killed. I mean, figure it out. If Dagon, or the other Godzilla that we saw in 2014, of its corpse, could be bested by Muto Prime, and there's kaiju more powerful than the very likes of Muto Prime, then it's possible that somebody could kill Godzilla. And when we also factor in that Ghidorah was able to lift Godzilla into the air and just hand his ass to him, and the humans came along to try and distract him, maybe Godzilla would have gotten his wits about him. But he was struggling. He was struggling with those Mutos. And there are kaiju that I think could kill the Mutos. So we have to take that all into consideration. Godzilla would not be top dog forever. They would evolve way faster than him. He can heal very fast, but not as fast as these creatures adapt to go to the surface and fight whatever they find as the biggest threat. In a weird, ironic way, these creatures are basically the Shin Godzillas of that world. They quickly adapt to face the biggest threat until they are virtually indestructible unless you freeze them or something. Maybe through time they would realize the people that Godzilla is a savior and he wants to help them. Maybe they wouldn't. There would be a big fight because some people would think he's one of the kaiju and he destroys cities, or that he's helping. Regardless if they try to help him or not, at the rate at which those things were reproducing, and if they didn't get that bomb down there or what have you, the Earth would just be obliterated by these things. Even if they nuke Godzilla to juice him up, it would only be for a short while. It's like a mushroom power-up in Mario. The minute you eat it, you can get big until you waste through all of it and something knocks you off your high horse and you lose it and you're back to square one again until you get another one. That's also what happened in Godzilla King of the Monsters. He didn't keep that nuclear energy or that fire mode for very long. It seems as though it's only under certain conditions. So unless they have the power to keep nuking Godzilla continuously, they would eventually lose the fight, both the humans and Godzilla working together, sadly. In a weird way, Godzilla showing up would actually expedite the extinction of humans, because these monsters would see him as a bigger threat than the Jaegers, and so they would adapt a lot faster to the more immediate and most dangerous threat. So Godzilla would just facilitate them adapting quicker to be more dangerous, if that makes sense. Anyways, what do you guys think? What would happen if Godzilla was in Pacific Rim? Let us know in the comments, and thanks so much for watching. This has been Ultiori. You ask, we answer.